Hello, I'm Dan Matatina. Thanks for inviting me here. I'm a designer and illustrator, and I love playing board games and video games. And today I'll be talking about the nonlinear path I've taken as a creative person. But before that, here's a quote brought to you by Edward de Bono. This is sort of like the biggest quest for most creative people, because when we design, when we create something, we want it to be very different. And Edward de Bono said that creativity is one of the most important resources of all. And the role of creative people, not just in design, but maybe in business and in other things, is to break those patterns and always find a different way, a different path. So for me, my journey started in Tacloban City. I was born there. I went to grade school and high school in Tacloban. I was more into like the science and engineering path. But when you're from the province, usually your path is given to you, or the choices you have is a bit limited. I can either become a lawyer, or a doctor, a nurse, or an engineer. But for me, I thought it wasn't for me. And when I was in fourth year high school, and when I was taking the UPCAT, I had the decision to make. It's either I listen to my parents and teachers, or I don't listen to them at all. So obviously, I did the best. I picked the best choice, which is not to listen to them. So, much to their disappointment, I took up fine arts. To just give you a sort of zoomed out map of my whole creative career, this is it. From fine arts, I went into advertising. And then after advertising, I started my first studio together with four other friends. It failed, we closed shop. And then I became a teacher three times in different schools. I started my next studio, became a consultant, illustrator, among other things. So as a creative person, I was always trying different things, and like what Spikitik said, diving into uncertainty, and it's always been my story. So I've had this aversion for the long, boring path, and for my career, it's always 5 years. And after every 5 years, I try something different, something very risky, much to the dismay of my parents again. Pero proud naman yung parents ko sa akin, but you know, parang I just give them headaches. So when I left advertising, I started a design studio for nonprofits with four other friends. And that was our first quest as a party. We wanted to be a design studio for nonprofits to help them. And at that time, we had a realization. While we were doing really good work for clients that we loved, our skill wasn't at the level of passion. And so that was one of the realizations we had. For me, I thought maybe I should be a better designer and learn more from it. And so at that time, we stumbled. And I think stumbling is part of every creative person's career. But the thing that you should take off from stumbling is to make sure that when you stumble forward. And so for us, the three other members of the design studio, we formed a different design studio called Plus 63. And this is when we decided that when we want to start our new studio, we would be very different from the others. And like what Edward de Bono said, parang it's always trying to look for the path that's trying to break patterns. And as a designer, as a studio, we have our process, which isn't very unique. But what's unique maybe is how we think of solutions to our different clients. So I'll share some of the works that we've done at Plus 63. The first one is for Back Alley Barbershop. And they asked us to create a branding, but apart from that, we created a GC program for them. So they asked us, can you make a gift check for us? And we thought, oh, sige, but we'll make it very different. That sort of reflects your personality. So this is the solution. We created a gift coin. It's like a cardboard that when the clients go to the shop, they can pop out the coin and redeem it in the shop. The shop keeps the coin, they can keep track of the people who use the GCs, while the client keeps the card and has all the details. So inside the shop, the client puts them in a jar to sort of collect all the gift coins that has been redeemed. And for us, when we design something, we always think there's a different way. And for a GC, there's always a different way in producing a gift check program. The next one is for Kushikatsu Daruma. It's a brand from Osaka. And most of the time, when a foreign brand comes in, they usually just sort of import the personality of that brand locally. And for Daruma, their shop in Osaka looked a bit more traditional. very basic Japanese design, which isn't bad, it's really good. But when we wanted to import it here, we sort of wanted to introduce and inject a different personality to it. And this is the color scheme. It's a bit more brighter, also approachable and casual. We designed our own typeface based on the typeface that they had. And we worked with KM Interior Design to create the interior, which is very different from what you saw earlier. So it's modern, but still has a touch of the Japanese personality. And for Kushikatsu Daruma, the most important part of this is retaining its authenticity. And being authentic doesn't mean it has to be very traditional. It just means that the core, the spirit of the brand should be there, which for Daruma, Kushikatsu Daruma, is the Osakan brand of humor. And we created our own Daruma dolls with our faces, sobrang vain. And then we had to make sure people get that you can't double dip inside the shop. So we created a bunch of public service announcements inside the shop telling people not to double dip because that's what's going to happen to you if you double dip. And we sort of had fun doing this. We even created moving posters inside the shop showing various punishments. And we had to be very creative about it so people are not offended. And so this also translates not just to the PSAs inside the shop, but also to the menu and the other materials inside the shop. So all throughout the menu, you can see someone chasing the dude who double dipped. There's a bit of readability problem, but it's still fun. And people who use the menu sort of had fun looking throughout all the illustration and visuals. And like what I said earlier, you can be very authentic without being too traditional. The third one is called Move Philippines. It's a disaster preparedness game we designed and created for Japan Foundation. And most of the time when you create disaster preparedness program, it's very serious and academic. And because we wanted to target kids, we designed this and created this in a way that it was very playful and fun. So this is the whole materials. We created card games, objects, among other things. And we went to CDO. That was the pilot program. The survivors of Typhoon Sendong were there. So we worked with them, talked to them, and developed the games. The studio, Plus 63, worked with Nagata-san of Kito from Kyoto and Ruticorn Viticorn. They're also very designers, and we collaborated on this project together. So this is the identity system for Move Philippines. There are two mascots, Mon and Tara. So Mon, it because monkey. Tara, because Tarsier. So very creative. They have the color scheme of the Philippines. So we also created the identity for every game. We created 8 different games together with Nagata-san, the community, and Ruticorn. And we sort of divided the bandanas. Tara went to the students, and Mon went to the facilitators. So we went there. We worked with the students, both from public and private schools, and tested out the games. We had different games. We made them familiar in using daily objects you see daily as a life jacket, for example, for this. It's an empty plastic bottle. And also using garbage bags as makeshift boots. We also created memory card games wherein it teaches kids how to use a guava twig as a substitute for a toothbrush, among other things. And this one is a set of goggles that sort of simulates that experience when you're under the flood. And when we talk to the survivors, that's what they told us, that when you're under the flood, you'd only see what's in front of you, but not what's on your periphery. So we had them go on an obstacle course, banding together, so they become familiar what they need to do if there's ever a flood. And of course, because it's a game and it's through play, sometimes kids have too much fun. So for this particular example, most probably dead na yung guy. But we had to let them redo this because it has to be proper. And while it's play, it has to be done in such a way na they can use it practically. And after every game, we gave them a passport wherein they can stamp and receive a prize afterwards. So this is about empowering children with life-saving skills through play. And it's very important that you're always thinking outside the box or taking a different path. Well, it's always good to be with like-minded people, with other designers, or working with my studio. It's always nice to go on a quest, on a path by yourself. While it's hard, it's always worth it. And for me, as an illustrator, I just work by myself doing different projects for different brands. And I still try to apply the sort of unconventional thinking. This is an illustration I did for Google Doodle. And for me personally, I thought maybe if I did something for Independence Day, I'll try to avoid from the usual visuals of Independence Day. This is the journey, like the creative journey I had, doing the sketches, submitting it to them. So I thought of a different way to show it. The first one is sort of a scenery that you usually see when you Google the Philippines and islands and beaches. And for me, I wanted to show it. Just not very celebratory, but very nice visuals and I don't know, more solemn. And the next one is a Carabao pulling a Google text, and the other one is people celebrating. Of course, hindi rin ako nakaabot sa celebration because it was a requirement, but I was okay. They picked the first one, so I developed more of the sketches, and I ended up with the third one, which shows the flag ceremony with the beach and the islands in the background. And because it's Google, people are familiar with the text, so it's a bit of a gestalt. You don't really see the whole text of Google, but kind of feel that it is. The next case study is an illustration I did for Qualcomm. Qualcomm asked, through their agency, asked me to develop a poster series for Formula E Championships. And most of the time, racing posters are very sporty, obviously, but we wanted to meld a bit of science and in a way, tourism and sport together. So I created sketches. The brief was to show the Formula E car, to show the flag of the country, to show the landmarks, and Qualcomm's patents. Sobrang hirap to add like diagrams and patents on the posters. But I had to find a way. And so these are the different sketches I did, always showing the flags, features of the flag, together with the landmarks and the car. And these are the final illustrations. So that's for Punta del Este in Uruguay, Buenos Aires in Argentina, so you can see the sun and all the elements and the colors of the flag, but melded in such a way that it looks very dynamic and it looks very postery. And for Beijing and Putrajaya in Malaysia, so all the flag elements are there if you're familiar with the flags. For the USA, I did two for Miami and Long Beach, so I had to visualize it in a different way. It still shows the stars and stripes, and it looks very familiar, but in a different angle. And the last set is for Moscow and London. My personal favorite is the one for London because very obvious and very nice. Pinuri yung sarili. So it's about combining science, the sport, and the flag. And the thing about questing by yourself is you get to know yourself more. And while for me personally, I love doing things my own, it's always nice to be part of a bigger group. So apart from doing Plus 63, we decided to fold in together as Hydra. Hydra is composed of four different studios, Ink Surge, Acid House, KM, and Charles, us. It's sort of a design collective so we can work on more challenging projects together. It's a pioneering thing, especially here in the Philippines, and it's another path not everyone takes. And because it's a path not everyone takes, I'm sure we'll have a hard time and we'll stumble forward. It's risky, but it keeps us on our toes. And for every creative people, that's always the challenge. How do you come up with fresh ideas? How can you come up with new ideas? But because we're a big studio, we can take on challenges, big challenges, confidently. And if we do fail, there will be a lot of us failing. And gives peace of mind to myself. Okay, hindi lang ako, hindi lang ako. So, our first project is for ourselves. Sobrang ano na, sobrang makasarili. But I think it was like our test program. We opened a coffee shop in front of our studio, which is Poison Coffee and Donuts. So, for Poison, we call it Poison because it's in the mouth of our office, the Hydra. And it's also called Poison because the food we serve and the drinks we serve are not healthy. It's not good for you. But we're not doing false advertising. It's true. But it's really good. So when you go inside the shop, it's so dark. So if tita yung pumasok, parang, what's this shop? It's so dark. It's not for me. So it's sort of like a kind of handicap we gave ourselves to give pressure to the food and drinks. And because it's a shop created by design studios, we Acid House did sort of screen saver projections on the wall. So it's about donuts. And before I forget, we sell donuts. So if you have time, please go to Hydra and Poison. It's in Makati. We really serve good donuts. And for us, because we have to take a different path, we wanted our coffee and donut shop to be very different from the usual. So what's next for us? And what's interesting for us is, I had this conversation with Kyle earlier. When you're a designer or a creative person, doesn't mean you're just doing design and you're working with businesses and trying to think strategically in every challenge or problems that clients give you. And for us, it's always with that, trying to help businesses strategizing and designing for them. To conclude, there's no wrong path to take. It's always encouraged to veer away and take a non-linear path, and it's always exciting that way. If you reach a dead end, don't worry. It means you can build your own path. Because it's new, you'll likely stumble, but you'll stumble forward. Thank you for having me here. I had so much fun.